Okay, so now let's look at astable multivibrator, how you can make it by using 555 timer IC. So here you can see the circuit. Now it is quite similar to what we had in mono stable, but now we have a resistor between 6 and 7 terminal, and our trigger signal is connected to the capacitor voltage, you can see. So the triggering will be controlled by the voltage stored in the capacitor. Okay, rest of the circuit is similar to what we had before. Now how the internal architecture pure will look like, this is how it will look like. So R1 R2, 7 terminal, then there is capacitor connected to ground is first terminal, then the resistances are same, voltage division is same. So here 5, 5, and 5 resistances are there, which will provide 2/3 VCC here and 1/3 VCC here. Okay, this is VCC. RS flip flop is same, upper and lower comparator is same, QT is same, inverter is same, this transistor is same. Okay, so upper comparator UC, lower comparator LC, and plus saturation means logic 1 on, minus saturation means logic 0 off. Okay, same thing. Now what will be the change here in the working, that we will see. So first, let's say initially capacitor is uncharged, means VC will be 0, upper comparator will be off, lower comparator will be on. Okay, means R will be 0, S will be 1. R will be 0, S will be 1, which will provide Q bar is equal to 0. If Q bar is equal to 0, means output will be high and QT will be off. Okay, as QT is off, the capacitor will charge through VCC. Capacitor will charge towards VCC, and through R1 and R2 it will charge. Okay, VCC, R1, R2, capacitor will charge, and a capacitor will try to reach VCC. Okay, capacitor is trying to reach VCC, but when VCC increases 2/3 VCC, which is this voltage, then UC will be on, because positive terminal is on more than negative terminal. LC will be off. Why LC will be off? Because the voltage is this voltage is greater than 2/3 VCC. So here this terminal is 1/3 VCC, this terminal is greater than 2/3 VCC, so this will be off, this will be on. Okay, so R will be 1, S will be 0, which will give output Q bar is equal to 1, flip flop output. So the output at terminal 3 will be low. Okay, and QT will be on. Now when the QT will be on, it C tries to discharge through the R2 resistor. Okay, this resistor, capacitor will try to discharge through this path, this C, R, then this 7, then this transistor, and then this, it will try to discharge. Okay, so that is how the discharging will happen. So discharging time constant is R2C. Charging time constant will be R1 plus R2C. Okay, so now what will happen? Again, once the discharging is happening, so capacitor will voltage will go down. Once it will go below 1/3 VCC, upper comparator will be off, lower comparator will be on. Okay, because this voltage is now less than this voltage, and this voltage is now less than this voltage, so it is connected to positive here, it is connected to negative here. So R will be 0 or S will be 1, you can say, because this will be off and this will be on. So Q bar will be 0 means output will be 1, output will be high, and Q transistor will be off. Then again, if Q transistor is off, now the capacitor will charge toward VCC through R1 and R2 with time constant R1 plus R2C. But when the voltage will increase greater than 2/3 VCC, this same stuff will happen and it will go on. So the capacitor charge will switch between 2 by 3 VCCs to 1 by 3 VCC. Okay, and the output will go, this output will go from plus Vsat to minus Vsat. Okay, so I hope you are able to see it, how the things are working. Now we will see the waveform, which will give you a clear picture of how the circuit is working. So here you can see the waveform. Okay, this will give you a clear picture. So this is the value of V naught, this is the value of Vc. So when the for the initial state capacitor was uncharged, it was carrying 0 volt. Once supply will be provided, capacitor starts to charge from R1 and R2. Time constant will be R1 plus R2 into C, and it tries to reach this VCC. But when it will cross 2 by 3 VCC, the comparators, lower comparator, upper comparators, state will change and capacitor will try to reach 0 volt. Okay, because it wants to try to discharge to 0 volt through QT transistor. It will try to reach this guy. But it, as soon as it will the capacitor voltage will be less than 1 by 3 VCC, it will again change, because the upper comparator, lower comparator will change. Again it will go to 2 by 3 VCC, and then again 1 by 3 VCC, 2 by 3 VCC, 1 by 3 VCC. That's how capacitor will behave. And at the output, the terminal 3, the output you will get plus Vsat, minus Vsat, plus Vsat, minus Vsat, plus Vsat, minus Vsat. Okay, that is how the circuit will work. So you will get a square wave at the output. Now one thing to mention here, that charging time is different than discharging time. They are not equal, because in charging time you will see R1 plus R2C, and discharging time you have R2C. So they are unequal. So at the output you have unsymmetrical square wave. Okay, due to continuous charging and discharging of capacitor between this half VCC and 2 by 3 VCC, we get square wave oscillation. Okay, so I hope by the waveform it is clear to you how the things are working. Now let's look at the time period. So time period will be the total of on time and off time, okay, or charging time or discharging time of the capacitor. So first, charging time, if you will calculate, again capacitor equation we will use, Vc is equal to Vf plus Vin minus Vf e to the power minus t divided by tau. So input voltage is, initial voltage is 1 by 3 Vcc. It is trying to reach Vcc, but with the time constant R1 plus R2C, but at t is equal to th, the voltage will reach to 2 by 3 Vcc. If you plug the value, you will be able to get th value is equal to 0.69 R1 plus R2C. Okay, if you will solve. So we are using this part of the circuit, okay, from here to here. Okay, so this first cycle you can neglect, because it was initially uncharged. It will try to settle between, it will take one or two pulses to settle between plus 2 by 3 VCC and minus plus 2 by 3 VCC and 1 by 3 VCC. So it's better to take from here, this guy. So initially it was 1 by 3 VCC. It is trying to reach to VCC, this VCC value, but it will reach till 2 by 3 VCC, and this time will be the charging time. Okay, so that is how the capacitor equation will be used, and you got the expression 0.69 R1 plus R2C. Now let's look at the discharging time. So discharging time, if you will see, again we will use the same equation for capacitor discharging, but this time initial voltage will be 2 by 3 VCC. Final voltage, it is trying to reach to 0 volt because of QT transistor, with time constant R2C, and at T is equal to TL, Vc is equal to 1 by 3 VCC. Okay, so for this, if you will plug the equation and you calculate the value of T, you will get discharging time is equal to 0.69 R2C. Okay, so you can see that they both are different, charging and discharging time are different. So total time will be 0.69 plus into R1 plus R2C plus 0.69 R2C, which will be T is equal to 0.69 R1 plus 2 R2C. This is the time period of oscillations, okay? And the time will be, it will be, the wave will be unsymmetrical, okay? And the frequency of oscillation will be 1 by T. So this you already know that. So finally, this will be the expression. F is equal to 1.45 divided by R1 plus 2 R2C. So it depends upon the capacitor value and the two resistances by which it is charging and discharging capacitor. Okay, you can also calculate a quantity called duty cycle, which is on time of the pulse divided by the total time period. This is the total time period, okay? And on time is 0.69 R1 plus R2C, and total time is 0.69 R1 plus 2 R2C. 2 is there. So if you will cancel it, you will get R1 plus R2 divided by R1 plus 2 R2. And if you want to calculate in percentage, you multiply by 100. Okay. But here you know that the output is symmetric, unsymmetrical. So what if you want to have a symmetrical wave at the output? Then you just need a diode to do this. Okay. We will see this. It is... here you can see. So to get a symmetrical wave, square wave, select the values R1 and R2 same. This R1 and this R2 should be same, so we are considering R, and connect a diode across R2. So you connect the diode in this fashion and you will get a square wave. Okay, how? Because at the charging and discharging time you will have R1C and R2C now, which is same as RC. Can see, because you have considered 2R. So the charging will be done through R1 and this diode and capacitor, whereas discharging will happen in this fashion. So capacitor R2, and then this will go inside. Okay, so for charging time diode will be on, for discharging time diode will be off, and that is how you are getting symmetrical wave. So you can see the charging time is 0.69 RC, discharging time is also 0.69 RC, provided these two resistor values should be same. Okay, and you will get 50% duty cycle in this. So I hope it is clear how we are manipulating this circuit. So for this guy, if you will see, the total time period will be 1.38 RC, duty cycle will be 50%, frequency will be 1.38 RC. Okay, now let's look at the problem. Okay, on this, so you have same scenario here. So you have a resistance here, R1, R2 resistance. There is a capacitor of 1 nanofarad, 0.01 microfarad. Output is here. For the timer circuit shown, calculate the range of frequency of oscillation generated by this circuit. So we have to calculate the range of frequency of oscillation. Okay, so here you can see the value of this resistor can be changed. Okay, the value of this resistor can be changed depending upon where the cursor is. So it can be 0 or it can be 10 kilo ohm. Here it can be 0 or 20 kilo ohm. Okay, so we will see the range of frequencies. So clearly you can see the R1 value can be between 5 kilo ohm to 15 kilo ohm. As I said, when this will be set to 0, then it will be 5 kilo ohm. If this will be set to 10 kilo ohm, then it will be 15 kilo ohm. Okay, so 5 to 15. Similar case here also, 15 to 20, 35 kilo ohm. So R1 and R2 will vary in this fashion. Now you have frequency of oscillation is equal to 1.45 divided by R1 plus 2 R2C. So if you plug the value, 1.45, R1 is 5 plus 2 into R2. These two values I have plugged. So you will get maximum. Okay. And C is same, 1 nanofarad. So if you plug the value, you will get 41.425 kilohertz. when you plug the other two values, 15k plus 2 into 35k, this which is this, you will get f minimum, which is 17.05 kilohertz. Okay, so the more the value of will be the maximum value, the minimum value of resistances you will choose, the maximum will be frequency, since it is inversely proportional. Okay, now let's look at another problem. So here you can see RA, RB is given to you. Capacitor is 1 nanofarad given to you. So here you can see that 10 kilohertz with 60% duty cycle, find the value of R1 and R2. Okay, so frequency is given to you, frequency of oscillation. It is a 60% duty cycle. So frequency, you will apply the formula 1.45 divided by R1 plus 2 R2C. You plug the values, you will get R1 and RA and RB relation, that is RA plus 2 RB is equal to 145 kilo ohm. Now you apply the duty cycle formula, you will get another relation. So here you can see another relation you can get is RA plus RB divided by RA plus 2 RB into 100, which is 60% given to you. If you will use this RA plus RB, you will get 87 kilo ohm. So you have two equation, RA plus 2 RB is equal to 145 kilo ohm. One equation is RA plus RB is equal to 87 kilo ohms. So now you will get, if you will solve these two equations, you will get RA is equal to 29 kilo ohm, RB is equal to 58 kilo ohm. Okay. So these are the ways in which question can be asked on timer IC. And I hope the working is clear for monostable as well as astable multivibrator, how we can design by using just a timer IC and few bunch of resistors and capacitors. Okay.